Hello, my name is Marek Polit, and I'd like to invite you to the 12th part of the Grenton Academy, in which I will tell you about the possibility of using and how to configure the Grenton Multisensor module. The Grenton Multisensor is an innovative module which features several sensors in a very aesthetic housing. In one device, we have managed to include as many as 7 sensors that will help you create your configuration and will ensure the safety of household members in your systems. In the module, you will find sensors that you already know from our other devices, such as the temperature or light level sensor, but you will also find several sensors that will significantly improve the comfort and safety of life in your homes. First of all, there is a carbon dioxide sensor, a sensor that will help you take care of the air quality at home, and in a situation where the carbon dioxide level rises to a dangerous value, it will activate the ventilation and inform you about it. Another important sensor, also found in the multi-sensor module, is the air humidity sensor. The humidity sensor is particularly important in homes where we use wall or floor cooling. In such investments, water condensation after exceeding the dew point is a serious risk, so it is important to ensure and control the correct level of humidity. The appropriate level of humidity also ensures our well-being and, above all, extends the life of equipment in our home. The correct level is around 30 to 40% humidity. When it is falling or rising, the system can automatically start the dehumidifier or humidifier. Another very interesting sensor, which is also included in this module, is the sound sensor. The sound sensor, in addition to information about the noise level in our home, which also has a very significant impact on our health, allows us to perform some interesting functions. For example, if we have a multi-sensor module in the apartment which we rent, thanks to the information from the sound sensor, we will be able to know if the people in that apartment are not too loud. If we have a small baby, when it detects crying, the sound sensor can turn on soft lighting and automatically turn on lullabies. The atmospheric pressure sensor is another useful sensor which will inform you in time about upcoming weather change. Or, especially for people hypersensitive to sudden pressure changes, it will allow them to react early. In addition to a number of sensors which take care of our comfort and health, we have also added an IR controller to the module. The IR controller allows you to control any daily use household appliances and audio-video devices which we control using an ordinary infrared remote control. Thanks to this solution, you can easily connect your equipment with the Grenton system with one button, and by starting the cinema scene, the system can automatically close the roller shutters, adjust the lighting to this scene, and immediately automatically turn on the TV, audio equipment, and switch to the channel that you want to watch. Another useful feature of this solution is the ability to control many devices from one multi-sensor module, which means that if we have a TV, hi-fi audio system, projector, or air conditioning in a given room, which we control daily with an IR remote control, we can hide all these devices in one application and control them from one central point. In this case, if one of your remotes gets lost, it won't be a big deal. You'll always be able to control this equipment from one My Grenton application. The controller, thanks to specifically selected IR transmitters, allows us to achieve a range of up to 6 meters and can be mounted both against and on walls perpendicular to the devices we want to control. The remote's configuration is very simple. It does not use libraries that create a risk of there being functions that we will not be able to handle. We simply clone the buttons of the remote controls that we use daily. Thanks to this, we do not have to bring the entire remote to our system. All we have to do is select only the buttons that we use most often or every day, or those that enable integration. Thanks to this solution, the Grenton system can connect hi-fi audio equipment of an older generation, which, due to technological solutions, does not allow integration using internet protocols. The multi-sensor module has been designed to fit into any interior. The aesthetic glass housing with dimensions of 8 by 8 centimeters and mounting on a standard electric box without the need for dedicated special mounting kits allows you to easily adapt it to almost any surface. Aesthetic black and white colors will look great on nearly any type of wall finish. The module has a small frame. We put it in a square housing with dimensions of 8x8 centimeters, and its surface is made of black and white tempered glass. You do not need any special boxes to mount the module. It can be mounted on a regular, standard electrical box. Thanks to its small thickness, the module protrudes by about 8 millimeters from the wall. It will go well with most types of finish. The Grenton Multisensor is not just a module that replaces traditional remote controls. First of all, it is a tool that gives incredible control over what happens in our home. The system can inform us on an ongoing basis about the current carbon dioxide concentration, whether we have the correct level of humidity, and whether it is not too loud in our house, because too much noise also negatively impacts our health. Apart from the fact that the mobile app provides certain information, the system can also automatically react by itself if it detects that the read parameters differ from the norm and it should perform some action. The Grenton Multisensor, like our touch panels, is also a device. Four wires are used to connect the device. Two wires to power the device and two more wires to communicate with other system elements. Remember, the device should be connected to the system with a bus cable. For this, we recommend using the Grenton TF bus cable. The devices are connected to the system in a serial topology, as you can see now on the attached diagram. To the bus, the beginning of which we have in the electrical switchgear, we serially connect other multisensor modules, and we can connect them on one line of the bus with other elements, such as a smart panel or touch panel. Of course, remember that the maximum bus length is 300 meters, and it must be serialized. Mounting the module on the box is very simple. You don't need special dedicated boxes to mount the device. An ordinary standard round electrical box with a diameter of 60 millimeters is sufficient. Screw the steel ring onto the box, and then, after placing the device in the ring, turn it clockwise until you hear a click. And that's it. The entire assembly is very simple and very fast. It is very important, however, to choose the mounting location of the device itself. We recommend installing the device at a height of 2 meters. Such a height will allow you to read the parameters optimally from all the sensors in the device. If, on the other hand, it is crucial for you to read the value from a specific sensor, for example from a carbon dioxide sensor, then it's best to mount the module a little lower, at a height of 1.20 m. It is safest and most optimal to measure this gas at this height. If instead of reading sensor parameters, the most important thing for you is to control your RTV equipment, then you can simply mount the module under the ceiling or even on the ceiling itself. The maximum range of the IR transmitter is about 6 meters. However, remember that this is a straight line range. If your module controls a device located on a perpendicular wall, the range will be shortened. At an angle of approximately 60 degrees to the module, the range will be reduced to approximately half of the maximum distance. Now, let's see what the configuration of the multisensor module will look like. Take a look at how the multisensor configuration looks, and how you can use the sensors it features. After connecting the multisensor to our CLU module and adding it to the project, you will see 9 new objects. You will mainly see several sensors there. It will be a carbon dioxide sensor, described as air CO2 sensor, volatile organic compound sensor, described as air VOC sensor, a humidity sensor, IR transmitter, IR controller, light intensity sensor, atmospheric pressure sensor, sound sensor, temperature sensor, and information on the voltage of the multisensor module on our bus. And now, each of these sensors, when you see its built-in features or properties, returns values appropriate for the spectrum it measures. In the case of carbon dioxide, we will show the concentration of carbon dioxide in parts per million, which means expressed in ppm values. The value we read on my multisensor today is 400 ppm, which means that the room we are in has a low carbon dioxide concentration. In the case of the humidity sensor, the value we get will be a percentage, which means, for example, 39% humidity in the air. The sound sensor will show the noise level value expressed in decibels, and you can now see how this value is changing for us. Depending on how I speak, louder or quieter, the value here keeps changing. Each of these sensors listed has its own events that will be very similar to each other. In each, we will find the on-value change, on-value rise, or on-value lower events, which allow us to create and build a configuration in our system. I will now show a simple usage example for a sound sensor. We will create an example configuration. Suppose we own an apartment that we rent to young people. We don't want to have problems with our neighbors, so we will set the system in such a way that warns them when they get too loud. We create a new script. We can call it Alarm Too Loud. And then we will insert a condition into this script that will check the current sound intensity level in the room in which we are staying. I select the sound sensor from the list. I choose the value. And if the value read by the sensor is higher than 75 decibels, then it will turn on the alarm light in that apartment, warning the residents that it is a bit too loud by briefly blinking the light. I prepared this alarm earlier, so now I'll just add it to my project. And now, for this script to trigger when it's too loud, we need to connect it to the on-value change event in our sound sensor. So I select a sound sensor from the list, add the script I just created to the on-value change event, which means alarm too loud, and then, after sending the configuration, I will check how it will work. Okay, and now look, I'm in the room, I'm speaking with a similar voice volume, the system finds it fairly quiet. As soon as the noise level increases, the system will inform me that it's a bit too loud and that we should calm down a bit. You can use all of the sensors in the multisensor in a very similar way. In addition to the fact that the system itself will take an action, it can inform us about it by sending a push notification. In a situation where it is too loud in the apartment, or if we are afraid that our children will have a party, the system may send us a notification that it is too loud and it would be worth taking an interest in what's happening there. The situation is very similar with carbon dioxide measurement. If the system detects that the carbon dioxide level is too high in the apartment, house, or room we are currently in, it may automatically increase the ventilation speed and inform us about it. And if this value does not decrease, then we will also be able to react by opening a window and ventilating such a room. In addition to the sensors just mentioned, which mainly care for our comfort and air quality in the room which we are in, the multisensor module also features with an IR controller. We've already talked about how we can use it and what for. Now, look how to configure it. So, if we would like to add buttons from remote controls to the system, which we normally use to operate our RTV equipment, for example, the TV set, to teach our IR controller codes from the remote, we choose the Learn Code method. Select the first free record. There are as many as 100 fields available, to which we can save button codes. I select number 1, I run call, and now we can see that the diode on our multisensor starts blinking quite quickly. We take the remote control in our hand and press the button that we want to keep in the system. The correct recording is confirmed by a longer activation of the green diode. At this point, the button is saved in our system as the first one. I added the on button, but I would like to add a few more which I use on a daily basis. Next, under record number 2, I will add the volume up button. Saved. Under record number 3, volume down. At this point, my controller remembers three codes for turning on the TV, volume down, and up. Of course, we can now add buttons from other remotes. We're not limited to a remote from one device. Under subsequent records, we can save buttons for operating the stereo system, projector, or any other device that is normally controlled by an IR remote control. Okay, we have the button saved in the device's memory. We would like to trigger them. Here, in the Object Properties window, you can see the send code methods. So by triggering the previously saved code, we can run a previously saved function. However, handling it from the level of the configuration software is not very convenient, so I would like to be able to control this equipment from other devices that I have connected to the system. Let's start, for example, by connecting the control of our TV from the touch panel. We select the first button in my touch panel. Then, the on-click event, which means it's click-triggered, and select the IR controller from the list of objects, and then select the send code method with the number 1. In this case, after sending the configuration, pressing the button on the touch panel will turn the TV on or off. In this way, you can connect any devices that are connected to your system with the control of devices that you normally operate using infrared remote controls. You already know how to associate sensors included in the multisensor with the rest of the system's configuration. Surely, most of you also want to be able to read parameters from sensors, parameters of your home, in fact, from a mobile application. This way, you will know exactly what the current conditions in our home are and if they are good for our health. So now, I will show you how to quickly transfer the sensor set to the mobile device interface. We open our interface, and now look. If we just switch to the view of the modules in our tree, all we have to do is grab our multisensor module, move it to the interface page, select the multisensor widget template, and at this point, the entire set of sensors has been transferred to one aesthetically pleasing widget. Then all you have to do is send this interface to your mobile phone, and you'll be able to see what values there currently are in your home. Of course, you can also control any equipment which we have previously configured access from the IR controller level at the level of the mobile interface. We can move them in the form of separate buttons. By selecting any button on the right, we trigger the action in the same way as we previously configured the button in the touch panel, meaning I simply select the IR controller from the list and the code that I would like to send from the button. But you can also use ready-made widgets, which we have prepared especially for controlling our TV equipment, and then configure this view in a way that it is as convenient for you as possible, and so you can fit many devices in one mobile device. As you can see, the configuration of the multisensor module is very simple, and the set of sensors it contains significantly extends the possibilities and functions of our smart home system. Thank you for your attention, and I would like to invite you to the next part of the Grenton Academy, where you will learn, among other things, the possibilities and configuration of gate modules.